looks like fish, but this otsukuri, a type of sashimi, is anything but. I'm going to show you how to make a vegan otsukuri using watermelon. Hi, my name is Natalia, also known as Chef Rudakova. I'm a professional chef, a culinary instructor, and a food content creator. And this is Secrets of Fine Dining with Fine Dining Lovers. You might have heard before about the watermelon steak. A watermelon had been cooked to look and taste like meat. In fact, this is not a new idea. Top chefs had been long playing with perceptions around meat and fish substitutes. Watermelon prepared three ways is perfect as a fish replacement in this dish of vegan otsukuri. And it's just as tasty, I guarantee it. When it comes to the imitation of the popular animal source dishes, like sashimi for example, the key to success and one of the top best kept secrets is to treat the plant-based products the same way that you'd normally treat the animal-based products. Whenever it's possible, of course. So in our case, in 2 out of 3 watermelon preparations, we'll do just that. In the first watermelon recipe, we'll need to cure our very watery watermelon to get rid of all the extra liquids. For this, first you'll need to cut the rind of the watermelon and prepare a standard cure mixture with addition of spices. Just mix together kosher salt, smoked paprika, onion powder, ginger powder, and chili flakes. Then cover the watermelon with the curing mixture, wrap it up, and cure in the fridge. In 1 to 2 days, you can unwrap the significantly dehydrated watermelon and wash off all the extra salt and spices. Next, we are going to take this watermelon even further and do something even more unusual with it. We're going to barbecue it. For this, mix together white wine vinegar, vegetable stock, agave syrup, brown sugar, onion powder, garlic, smoked paprika, mustard, whiskey, fancy molasses, miso paste, liquid smoke, and a touch of pepper. And blend everything to a smooth consistency. That's basically our barbecue sauce. But before proceeding further, it needs to be reduced by half to get thickened up. Now we can lovingly cover our cured watermelon with this barbecue mixture on all the sides. Place it on a rack and bake for about 40 minutes at a preheated to 260 degrees Celsius oven, flipping it halfway through and adding more barbecue sauce if necessary. This first part of the recipe is done. However, there is nothing worse than a hot watermelon. So that's the point when we're going to treat our plant-based product differently, and we're going to completely cool it down in the fridge. Our watermelon, despite its being barbecued, will be served cold. In the second watermelon recipe, we're going to marinate our watermelon, just the same way as we would normally marinate a piece of tuna or salmon. For the marinade itself, we're going to prepare a sort of a miso glaze by mixing together dark miso paste, sake, mirin, and soy sauce, blending all the ingredients, bringing them to boil and cooling down over a nice bath. Once the miso glaze is completely cooled, pour it over the pre-cut watermelon slices, making sure that they can be completely covered with this marinade mixture. And let it sit in the fridge for about half an hour to fully infuse with all those umami flavors. Meanwhile, to keep it fun and rich in flavors, we're going to do what cooks normally do with their watermelon. No tricks here, just pure deliciousness. We're going to make a watermelon sorbet. This watermelon sorbet will serve as a palate cleanser in our vegan otsukuri. Sort of like a pickled ginger in regular sashimi presentation. In order to make a watermelon sorbet, we'll need to cut the watermelon in cubes, remove all the dark seeds and freeze them. Then we'll place these frozen watermelon cubes in a food processor, add some lime juice and syrup, and pulse until we get a nice sorbet consistency. Place back to the freezer until the assembly. When it comes to plating, you can try to recreate the traditional otsukuri presentation. Add a few garnishes or create beautiful roses with your watermelon. Basically, the world is your oyster when it comes to food plating. However, what's important is to keep a balance on the plate, both in terms of colors and flavors, and to create a sense of harmony and unity between the ingredients on the plate. I hope you've enjoyed this video and you've learned a little bit more about the mysterious world of fine dining today. Please check out other episodes in this series and discover the secrets of fine dining with me. Don't forget also to subscribe to the Fine Dining Lovers channel for more great food videos. And please share your creations on social media using the hashtag Fine Dining Lovers. I'm Natalia Rudakova, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.